Hello, I'm the internet. Welcome back to the lamest motive ever. Money.
Welcome back to Trump Initiative.
Yeah, pretty much. So that's the motive you prepared for us, is it? $10 million is... It's not nearly enough.
For him, it's not.
I mean, honestly, listen. I'm kind of desperate for money, but to kill someone, even I would say that's not enough. Like, I would need a lot of...
Put like 5 more zeros at the end of it.
Right.
Fuck.
Right. I would need a lot more to be willing to, like, just commit murder.
Just, like, grab Toko, grab her scissors out from wherever she keeps them. All right, who's dying, bitches?
It's true.
When it comes to motives, money certainly is the gold standard, so to speak.
I mean, everyone speaks the language of money.
Whether it's in a mystery novel or the real world. But there's no way we kill each other for money.
Of course.
She's right. We can't simply purchase a person's life.
You can say 10 million or however much. I don't give a crap. Serious. Yeah, they're all right. Whether it's 10 million or any other amount of money, it's not like... No. Not even just money. From now on, no matter what you do, we won't kill our friends. Come on, stop trying to act tough.
I can't wait.
The most important thing to do is live a pure and moral communal life. When Akuma disappears, leaving his words on stage along with the massive sum of money.
So anyone could just take it?
I guess.
Does that mean they have to commit the murder? I mean, someone could just take the money and no one would be any the wiser.
Or maybe it's like a contract thing, like, if you touch the money, that means you have to murder within 24 hours. If not, you're the one who dies. I don't know.
Maybe. Could you imagine the hero just go buy the money, he doesn't touch it, he just snips it?
This is what Trump smells like. Jeez. There's nothing to worry about, right? No one would kill a friend for money, right? Have you so quickly forgotten the lesson from the last time? You can't judge others by your own standards.
Yeah, there might be someone who is having money problems!
Personally, I have earned over $1 million for my gambling efforts. My life is comfortable.
I'm telling you!
Hey, Fumi? What about you?
You know nothing!
I'm a super popular content creator! I don't have any problem making enough to buy my comics and DVDs!
Yay!
Hey.
Just stop. Pressing others about their personal finances is ugly, Sakura's in total gambling debt.
Oh no.
Ugly?
Well, of course, that's the word you focus on.
That's the word you focus on?
We all know why. Don't worry. Either way, whatever's going to happen will happen without warning. That is the nature of this game.
I kind of want to see what happens when we talk to Toko more.
Is this just going to be the normal, like, hanging out?
I think so. Yep.
It's that time already, huh?
Hey.
Before we separate, let me remind you. Starting tonight, I'll be leaving my room open to make sure nothing happens to Alter Ego.
Ego?
Ego. Just because my door is open, don't assume that will make-
Byakuya and Toko don't know what that is!
What?
Byakuya and Toko don't know what Alter Ego is. They weren't there!
Oh yeah, you're right. Or the Predator might suddenly find itself to prey. Just like with Sakura. Or Sayaka. Dang it! Her voice was so calm and composed, but it was clear she meant what she said.
You know?
Okay. Let's just everybody head back to our rooms.
How about that?
And don't even think about the whole money thing. Got it? Good. Well, that's great.
Hmm.
How was that? Pretty good. Right, Taka? Right. As soon as I was back in my room, I crawled into bed. Money. That's no way to get anyone to kill anyone else. I told myself
I
that.
I mean, people do it all the time. They're called assassins.
Right. No, Mom, I'm not a psycho... What? How did it go? You know what I'm talking about? No, Mom, I'm not a psycho. I'm an assassin.
No, wait, no. No, Mom, I'm not a psychopath. I'm a killer.
I'm a hired killer.
Well, one's
a profession and another is personal sickness.
Yeah, something like that.
Yeah, it's a sniper.
Yeah.
Mom, put Mom on the phone.
After all, I thought the same thing last time about having our secrets revealed. Did I skip a line? Okay. Even if the reason for it seems completely nonsensical, a murder can still happen. Did I start my timer? Hold on.
Apparently not. We got through the lamest motive ever.
Okay, well, now my timer started. That's the last thing we learned. But this time it's different. I'm sure of it. Because of the program Chihiro left behind, Alter Ego, we finally have some small of hope to grasp onto. As long as we have that, then I'm sure.
Did someone say hope?
Take a drink.
It's just...
Oh, jeez. Okay, well.
Little kids have it so easy. Because they can put little in front of their name, and right off the bat, everyone thinks they're cute. Well, fine then. I want everyone to start calling me Little Monokuma.
No.
See? Just by adding that, my cuteness goes up at least, like, 10%, right?
No.
Yeah, the world doesn't have nearly enough littles. More littles would lead to the salvation of the world!
Isn't little spelled like that, like, the rap name version?
Yeah.
like Lil Debbie and Lil Debbie, you know, yeah. You've seen that meme.
Yeah. Just imagine, little arsonist, little war criminal, little destruction of the environment.
Yeah, these are all definitely rappers.
Little hit and run, little death tax, little Great Depression.
Even the darkest subject can suddenly become lighter. Our dreams are expanding, ding, ding.
Okay.
Could you imagine if this is just Makoto's dreams? He's just dreaming of Monokuma, like, I can't get this fucker out of my head. What the fuck is happening to me?
Right. And the shirt comes
Good
off.
Good morning, yeah, everyone. It is now 7 a.m. And nighttime is officially over. Time to rise and shine. Get ready to greet another beautiful day.
Baby, you're okay.
It's our mascot.
Well then, I guess I should head to the dining hall. Oh, I have to actually move there.
Yep, look around.
Yep.
More plates. Cameras.
Yay!
Hey! Gambling coins! We now have 10 gambling coins!
Well, I guess I could spend them at some point.
We can spend them afterward.
Yep.
Fucking toolkit.
Lint roller, the bed, trash can. Yay!
Do you think the lint roller wasn't replaced? Like, it still has that same amount of paper missing?
Probably.
Just as a constant reminder?
Yeah. What
are
you doing, baby?
What are
you doing?
Oh,
what?
What
happened? Oh. Okay. That looked
different.
I didn't even notice.
Oh, well.
Oh, well. Okay, well...
Hey, people are outside!
Alright. How about you, Sakura? Good morning, Sakura.
Did you just wake up?
Yeah.
Waking up for our breakfast meeting is fine, of course. Getting up a little earlier is better. You can exercise in your room till nighttime ends. A big meal after working up a sweat is divine.
Alright.
Yeah, I can say that.
Hey, Makoto.
Hey, morning, Makoto. Good morning. You're kind of sweaty. Have you been exercising?
You could say that.
Yep, me and Sakura have been doing a morning workout.
No, it's weird. Our crunch up just had me going into her butt. I don't know what.
Oh, but I didn't break our nighttime promise. I just ran around my room until 11.
Baby!
Kitty! Don't jump in front of my screen! I can't keep telling you I don't want you on my desk.
I like how he said it at the exact same time.
Right. Oh. Why didn't you come with us next time? I don't think I could keep up with you and Sakura.
Huh?
Seriously? Okay, well, we can do it something in the rec room. I'm not good at much, but I do know how to play Othello. I'm not very good at that either, though. Wait, did I read Makoto as her?
No.
Okay. I'm not very good at that either, though. I don't like to think what I'm playing, so... Okay, well, I'm gonna... Whoops. What?
Phew.
I learned a thing, apparently.
What?
That you can rotate using the Q and the E buttons.
Really? You just now noticed that?
I've never needed to. I have the mouse.
Why would you need to go to the trash room?
I'm just looking everywhere.
I'm the trash man!
Everyone's meeting up the dining hall. Okay. coin.
Okay.
Okay, well, I can talk to...
That's a Hifumi!
So I don't... I didn't mean to start your gut there.
Well,
hello. Ah! Good morning!
Morning.
Mm-hmm. Actually, it's a great morning! A morning that has blessed my entire future!
Really? Just like any other morning to me.
Maybe you can't tell, but my soul is positively overflowing with strawberries today. Well, I'm off!
That was bizarre. I mean, even for him.
And his chestnut body. Dude!
I wanted to see if I can talk to all three of you. Okay.
Could you imagine the mastermind just watching Makoto run around like a dumbass?
Yeah.
Could it be?
So, the people here today are the same as yesterday, just as seven. Mm.
Byakuya and Toko are a lost cause, but...
It looks like Taka's decided to stop coming for good, too.
It's like he's just given up.
For people wound as tight as he is, when you snap hard.
I wish there was some way to make him better.
Maybe he could snap into a Slim Jim.
Oh, jeez.
Brother!
Just Celeste! Everyone starts laughing, all of a sudden she goes, brother!
What the fuck?
On another topic, Kyoko, did everything go alright last night?
Indeed.
Yeah, I didn't have any problems.
Correct.
I went and checked on the laptop a little while ago, but there weren't any problems there either, but I said but too many times.
Kyoko seemed to hesitate, but...
Whew.
It's late to this case, so I suppose I should be blunt.
Anyway...
I have to make a new rule. Using alter ego without permission is prohibited. Someone going in and out of the dressing room would draw unwanted attention from the mastermind.
Oh!
I would have thought that would have been obvious. Why do we need to make a rule about it?
I wonder why.
That's a good question.
Hey.
Do you have any thoughts on that, Ruby?
Oh.
No, it's just like you said. We all need to be very careful.
Huh?
Oh, water! That's just hurry up and eat! I don't have time to stand around flapping our lips.
What? Jeez, why are you talking all pissed off, drill sergeant all of a sudden?
Let me see your warm face! Diner in warm face, this in warm face! Ah!
Yeah, okay. Friggin' Full Metal Jacket, right?
Yep. She's a wolf in mouse clothing.
Has anyone ever actually did like a fan-made crossover of Full Metal Alchemist and Full Metal Jacket? I'm sure it exists somewhere.
It probably exists somewhere.
We had breakfast in a rush, then headed back to our rooms.
We can now hang out with people, I think.
Free time?
I think so. Let's eat.
What should I do today? Free time!
Okay! Before we start free time!
Let me save.
Yeah. That too, but...
Oh, you want me to...
It is time to present... Your guess.
Hifumi.
Hifumi?
Hifumi.
Hifumi?
Hifumi.
Hifumi. It's a freaking International Church of Foamy.
He's been highly focused on this chapter. It has to be. Either he's the guy, he's a victim or he's a killer. I'm not sure which.
So you're gonna say victim for right now, right?
Yes.
Okay.
Okay, well...
Let's see where everyone else is.
Yeah, that's a good idea.
I mean, we always know where Toko is. In her room.
Yeah, Toko never leaves a room, does she?
Oh, she's not in her room this time!
Wow. Okay, let's see.
There's fucking Fumi.
You know what? Let's talk to him.
You want to talk to Fumi?
Yeah,
let's see if we can talk to Fumi.
If he's gonna die, I might as well get to know him.
Give him another Princess Pingle statue.
Right.
Well, hello.
Ah, Christina Yagi. What are meeting you here?
Mm-hmm.
A salute to you.
You.
Salute. I just saluted, did you see? That was the Fumi ultimate salute. Zam!
Going to hang out with your Fumi? Yes.
Cosplayer these days are so ignorant of the origin, the history, the significance of their hobby. If you don't know your history, you can never have a complete cosplay experience.
So Mr. Naegi, prepare for a glorious detailed history of the cosplay world. Now, in 1955.
I listened to Hifumi half obsessed ranting about for way too long. Hifumi, now you're a little mother today. Yes. Now I have a statue, right?
Yeah.
That's what I should do.
There it is! We have six of them!
I can just keep talking to him and keep giving him that, actually.
I was once a ruthless ubermensch, but Mr. Nagi has awakened my heart to the power of friendship! May I call you my master? What is thy bidding, my master?
Oh, damn. I didn't expect him to go this far. Think of so cute. Something I gave him makes me happy.
I see quality in you, Mr. Naegi. True quality.
Mr. Naegi!
And that's why I decided to...
Sorry.
Nose.
I've decided to present to you my lecture on the nature of fanfiction.
Why don't you learn your... Why don't you learn how to do your accent, Hifumi?
I said shut up!
Jeez.
If you're going to be friends, you must be fully informed. I will permit no fanfic bigotry whatsoever.
I don't think I have any fanfic bigotry. I mean, I don't really know anything about that kind of geeky stuff anyway.
See? There it is! To you, fanfic equals geeky, right? But is that all that word is worth?
Huh? Did I say something wrong?
But that's okay! Because I think the word geek as a compliment!
Good, me too.
For you see, there is no one on Earth so full of knowledge as a geek!
Yes, indeed.
In a sense, a geek is like an expert. That's right, a total expert. A successful musician must necessarily be a music geek. A good movie director is a movie geek, you see? And those experts, those geeks who open up the world to others. So when you say that writing fanfic is geeky, you're recognizing us as true experts!
Okay, so what exactly is fanfic then?
Here we go!
Oof. Super direct question, FTW!
Mm-hmm.
Basically, we all have kind of, we all...
Learning is good to fool me!
I said shut up, you bitch!
Whoa!
Basically, we have all different kinds of stores and events, right?
It really does just say stores! That's a typo! That has to be a typo! It's supposed to be stories, right? What? Come on.
These are where groups of holy warriors sell their own stuff based on games, comics, anime, everything!
Oh, it really was stores.
Yeah.
Never mind. I'm sorry.
I don't know what I'm talking about!
I'm sorry, Hifumi. I'm sorry I doubted you. You are clearly the master
Bigot.
Of this. I was about to give you a compliment, but I never mind. All the stuff people make is fanfic?
Comics are the most common creation, but it also includes games, music, and even merchandise.
By the way, there's a name for when a group of fanfic creators come together.
Is it called a convention?
Specifically, it's any organized group that comes together to release their work.
A convention? Okay. Try a circle. Is it a circle?
Aha, I guessed it! It sure is! Of course you knew that! I mean, it's only common sense!
We didn't say
convention first. No, fucking
circle!
We're not talking about this! We're not talking about this, or this, or we're talking about this!
Oh geez, I wonder how that's gonna pick up.
I hope it picks up weird. It's supposed to be weird.
Yeah. I'm too smart for this game, so
I totally knew the answer.
Right,
yeah.
I haven't gotten any wrong answers yet, except that one thing with Mondo. I didn't get it wrong on when Johnny's playthrough, so...
That's because you knew the answer.
Yes.
I certainly hope you don't expect me to explain such common sense topics every time.
Well, like I said, I don't know too much about this stuff.
This goes well beyond I don't know too much! But I guess I can't blame you. The propaganda never touches on that. So as a fanfic ambassador, by the time I'm done with you, you'll be itching to buy a premium pass to the next fanfic con.
So where is the convention?
Right?
Obviously he's excited, but...
That's it for today. I hope you're excited for your next lesson.
Sure.
Is it about smut?
I can't wait to see what the future...
That's me!
Shit.
I can't wait to see what the future has in store for the two of us.
I'm kind of scared to see what the future has in store for the two of us.
Oh, please. Handiwork!
Okay. Well, it's, you know what? I'm going to talk to Hoomy again.
Let's
I have six statues.
I know, but I want to see who else is there. I want to
find...
Because remember, they're always in different positions.
Yeah. So who else is in the cafeteria?
Oh, hello!
Okay, sounds like someone's here. I guess I don't get free time right now.
You got one free time. Oh. Taka!
Hi, Taka. How are you today? You look... Well,
I forgot about this.
Taka!
Is it true? Can I really see Chihiro?
Huh? You mean alter ego?
He's still alive?
No, not quite.
Let me see. I want to talk to him.
Taka, the way he is now, there's no way I can explain to him what's going on. Toko-san are not allowed to use alter ego.
Toko! Kyoko!
Kyoko. I don't know why I said
that. Freaking Toko's the ultimate detective now. She kills her people, then investigates their murders!
And it turns out the suspect was me all along! Wait a minute.
Just handcuffs her.
Right.
It's like, blast it, you fooling me again! Achoo! Ha-ha! I knew you would never do it! Achoo! Man, there is a lot of pollen. Achoo! Right? I know, right?
Wait a minute. Sneezing to change personality? Isn't that just like Launch from Dragon Ball?
Maybe.
Cause I'm pretty sure Launch also changed from sneezing.
I'm not sure, I can't remember. Anyway, but even so!
I can't just leave him here like this. Okay, why don't we get going?
I can see Chihiro take me.
Well...
Just don't get caught by any- Oh, hi, Kyoko!
Yeah, I was actually wanting to talk to you first.
Just a second.
Where are you going? Huh?
Hey.
It's probably best if you don't drag him around with you too much, given his current condition. Kyoko, look at Taka, standing right behind me. Yeah, I know that. But I was getting kind of hungry. Oh, come on. Just explain it to her, and maybe she would... But I was getting kind of hungry, so I thought we could head to the dining hall or warehouse or something.
Correct.
Well then, I guess it's okay. Thought I saw a brief flicker of doubt, but maybe it was just my imagination. Come on, dude! Be honest with her!
Just wait. Be honest! Hi, Genocide Jill!
Why are you back? Is that Toko?
What are you two up to? Don't tell me you're gonna... Having lost his new brother, Taka is ripe for the taking, so Makoto swoops in to steal him away! Are you fired?
I severely regretted talking to Genocide Jack, even if I accidentally...
You S.O.B. But that doesn't matter right now! Have you seen Byakuya?
Huh? No, I haven't.
God damn it! My love is being pushed to the limit!
I almost feel bad for him.
I don't.
Me neither. Anyone else want to talk to me before I go through with this?
Is anyone else in this hallway, you know, maybe want to stop me?
Right. Hey, Kyoko, you wanna leave your door open just in case? Okay, well.
You know, maybe it just seems like a very dangerous thing to do.
Right. Okay, so there's a laptop inside the locker, understand? And on the laptop, there's a program called the Alter Ego.
How do I talk to him?
Oh, well, you just tell him what you want to say, and I'll type it in for you.
Do you hate Mondo? And since I couldn't stop him, do you hate me?
It was clear he was forcing himself to get the words out. from his mouth, from the bottom of his heart, he was forced to, in his weakened voice, to make sounds.
Please.
Okay.
So,
do you hold yourself responsible?
But...
if Master could talk now, I think this is what he would say. Please, live your life for the both of us. It's impossible for me now, but you can still survive and escape. All of you. Hey, Taka. I was about to say more, but quickly close my mouth.
Hey!
The one asking questions is Taka, right? Analyzing all available data, that's the only conclusion I can come up to. Master told me how close Taka and Manu have become, so that must be why he feels responsible. The screen's only one dark. I wonder who next was.
Stop fucking around!
What?
You're not letting yourself get crushed under the weight of that responsibility, are you? You okay?
I'm processing.
I mean, if he can copy Chihiro, there's no reason that he can't copy anyone else.
Yeah, I just saw that Chihiro put himself. I didn't think he put any of the other students.
No, like he's faking it.
Oh.
He may have put it in like their pictures, but like he's probably faking it.
Okay.
Yo.
A man's only worth as much as the load he can carry. You get it, right, bro? Hell, what am I saying? Of course you do!
That's...
no.
I'm sorry if I startled you. That was my attempt at a simulation, using the data about Mondo that Ma started giving me. I figured if Taka was depressed, that's the kind of thing Mondo would have said to him.
Yo.
So you're just gonna stand there, huh? Just wait for things to get better? Just take your time and get all depressed. Take the time to indulge your regrets. You might even start walking again without realizing it. Sure, that kind of mediocre thinking might work for some people.
What if I said it was kind of condescending tone? With a kind of condescending tone? Taka? Oh, jeez.
It's starting to sink in. The way a bucket of water sinks into a bone-dry sponge.
Huh?
Those words, deep within my heart, they're inside of me.
Did he just turn Super Saiyan?
I'm so glad you said it.
Taka?
Who the fudge is Taka?
What? Your eyes.
F you.
Hey, don't worry about it. Guess that caused kind of a scene, huh? Shoot, man.
And your voice.
Yeah.
I'm a new me. Ah! I'm totally stuffed with fighting spirit now, you dumbbot!
What? Okay, Taka. Just calm down.
What?
I am calm! And don't call me Taka! That's not my name anymore. I'm me! I am me!
I am concerned.
I am scared.
Taka let out a bone-chilling howl and ran out of the room. Hey, Taka, hold on. I took off after him, but someone stood in my way.
I wonder who it is.
Yep, saw this coming. As if tagging Taka out, she walked briskly into the dressing room.
Just a second.
What do you think you're doing? Kyoko! Oh, no, you see, this is just...
enough already.
Don't go around doing whatever you feel like. It causes problems. Not just for me, for everybody. Sorry.
Correct.
If you're really sorry, you'll get out of here. Now. Okay.
I mean, she didn't smack a bitch, so...
yeah. Finally, I headed back to my room, embarrassed and sullen. Oh boy, well.
Mondo went Super Saiyan.
But still, what was the Taka's sudden freak out? I'm seriously worried about him. Yeah. It's not done already, I guess I'll have to wait tomorrow to find out. Time for sleep. Monokumadier.
Yep.
You want to know why I hate video games? Oh!
You're in a video game!
Yep. You might not believe this, but I had a best friend once. Actually, he was my only friend. But unlike me, he had all kinds of friends. So me and him were at his house one day when a big group of guys showed up to hang out. They just bought the latest big budget video game. They sat at a loss in the game, passing the controller back and forth for hours. But not me. I just sat there watching. That's right, I just watched. What's wrong with that? I didn't care.
Yeah, I mean, watching someone play a video game can be fun.
I mean, they're doing it right now.
That's true. Anyone else is doing it right now? Hello!
Hi, people! Hi, people of the internet. Hello, people of the internet.
Right, exactly.
Just by watching, I was able to nail down all the best strategies. Even though I never actually played it.
And I don't plan on ever playing it in the future, either.
Okay.
Then, you said you had a friend. What happened to your friend? Did you kill him?
Probably.
Kidding.
Ah, morning. Alright, I need to hurry up and get to the dining hall. I need to tell everyone what happened to Taka yesterday. I'm sure they already know, considering he's probably there.
And thus the birth of Kiondo Ishida!
Is that what he calls himself?
Yes. The mixture between Mondo Iwata and Kiyotaka Ishimaru.
I see.
Kiondo Ishida!
So what do we call him for short?
Taka?
Oh, so it's called Taka?
People keep calling him Taka. He doesn't want it. Also, you can't really talk to him at this moment.
I was making sure that... Oh no.
What?
He's probably gonna die that way.
You know?
Yo, I've been waiting. Huh? Are you the only one here? Where's everybody else? They went on ahead. Went on ahead to where?
Hey, come on.
We can talk about it later. For now, let's go take a bath. Bath.
Someone help!
Mifumi, what's going on?
I got help, save me. I never asked you for anything, but I'm asking now.
What happened?
She's trying to kill me.
Mifumi pointed at... Huh? Kyoto's trying to kill you?
What? Did you look up porn?
Okay, well.
I told you not to do that on the alter ego.
Hiro, what the heck is going on? Well, I honestly have no idea. Why not have Kyoko fill us in?
Oh my god!
So, Sakura, what happened?
I don't know.
What?
But considering where we are, it must have something to do with the laptop.
Makoto, please have mercy on me!
Maybe she here at Sunga's papers.
You are late.
Sorry. So what happened?
I don't know too much about it. You should talk to Kyoko.
You know, what in the world happened? I'm not really sure, but...
Yeah!
But if Uli said did something bad, I'm pretty sure of it.
Like I said, you looked at porn on the old reader.
Don't do it the other way! You gotta help me! She wants to kill me!
Okay, fine. I never said I was going to kill him. I simply asked him a question. I'd like to know why.
Oh, what happens when you... What happens when you don't click it?
Just ask.
Son of a bitch!
I simply asked the question, same mistake twice. The same mistake? What did he do?
So...
He snuck into the dressing room in the middle of the night and accessed Alter Ego without permission. And when I caught him last night, he was hugging the laptop and breathing strangely.
Oh my god!
What were you doing? I thought I made myself clear yesterday, but since being subtle didn't work,
listen to me.
I suppose I'll have to clarify myself further.
Please don't kill me!
Wrong.
I'm not going to kill you. Merely instruct you.
Very sad.
Okay.
So talk to him. You have to talk to him then. So click on everyone else besides him!
What?
I just want to hear him explain himself. Probing the laptop and breathing all creepily on it? Seriously, what were you doing?
sounds like the same one.
Honestly.
I have an idea what he was getting up to, but... ugh, just ridiculous.
I see.
Whatever it was, I can't help but be suspicious.
Yeah, but I have a pretty good idea what he was getting up to. Probably not what he said, but whatever. It was close enough. Hifumi, could you tell me what happened?
I was just talking!
However,
which was prohibited, was it not?
You see... Kaka here, we were just so much fun, and I just...
Whoa, okay, time out. I can't even believe I'm about to ask this, but... Hifumi, you're not gonna tell us you fell in love or something, are you?
The cold-blooded killing machine in the underworld! Underworld! Whenever I fall in love, that's...
Well...
No way! Is this love?
According to the spirits...
I have now to do a psychic reading for a certain famous CEO once. And that guy was seriously head over heels for a mannequin. He was at a wedding and everything.
How about that?
And your eyes, just now! It was the same look in his eyes!
You know nothing!
Shut up! She ain't not a mannequin! She's an angel!
I feel as if...
And don't bother telling me angels exist! What we have cannot be defined by your petty words.
Yeah, you're totally in love. So, how did things end up like this?
Well, at the beginning, I just wanted to hear it say Master one more time. But then I was poking around at her settings and stuff, and saw she was a well-designed program. And I was like, how can I say... It was the first time I was able to talk to it like that with a normal girl.
But she's definitely not a normal girl.
I think that's the reason why he could.
Even when all we did was talk about my hobbies and stuff, she wasn't annoyed or disgusted or anything.
Your stories are so interesting, Hifumi.
Oh my god. This is dude, it's like that waitress. It's like that waitress at Hooters. She's not interested in your stories, bro. She's interested in that sweet, sweet data.
Come on, tell me more. I want to learn everything you have to teach me.
I suppose...
That's the first time a girl's ever said anything like that to me. Besides my mom, I mean.
Hey.
Your mom says stuff like that to you? That's kind of amazing all by itself.
What kind of mom do you have?
That's why I was just so happy. It was so much fun! And before I knew it, I found myself, you know, liking her. Her face, her personality, her voice, even her keyboard.
She has a virtual penis!
Also, you could have gotten along with the real Chihiro, but no!
You're just interested in the one that wants all that sweet, sweet data!
Right.
Well...
Even the keyboard?
I think you have misunderstood the situation, Hifumi.
Are you okay with this?
Alter Ego was not interested in who you were. It was interested in what you knew. It is an artificial intelligence. It exists to learn. Of course it wanted to hear of things it did not know. You are an expert in many things Chihiro could not have taught it about, for what that is worth.
Honestly.
Alter Ego wants that information. That is all.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking too.
I know that.
I know. I mean, I do know that, but still. Are you saying it's totally hurt, hopeless?
You gotta be freaking kidding me!
Damn you!
Hey, you jerks! I'm sitting here listening to you guys jibber-jabber on about whatever!
Yo!
Oh, Taka, are you back?
Who the hell's Taka?!
You?
Listen up! I'm me! Got it?
What the heck?
You're who?
What?
Don't bullcrap me! Isn't it obvious? I'm Kiyotaka and Mondo! So like, Kiondo, I guess. I'm gonna snag a banana up your tailpipe!
What?
What the heck of a fusion is this?
Fusion? Ah! You didn't do it with me.
You fused with a dead person.
Use the soul of a dead person.
What's happened to you, Taka? Actually, told everyone what happened to me before.
Well, then.
So, because of what Alter Ego said to him.
Are you sure it's Alter Ego's fault? Maybe Mondo's ghost showed up and possessed him.
Ghost? There's no such thing.
What are y'all whining about? Come on!
What?
God, you're really chasing me off.
Hey, Ifumi.
That's me. What?
Shit.
Yes?
Yeah.
I don't know what you're thinking, but...
For some reason, I thought it was, Makoto that said that.
Oh my god.
F you.
Bro belongs to me! Bro?
Belongs to you?
You... If you... There is so many things wrong with that sentence.
Huh?
Yeah.
Alter Ego. He's an exact copy of the one who gave me my soul back. And I'm not gonna let anyone else have him ever again. Fudging idiot.
I'm afraid. I can't allow that.
What?
So it would seem.
I can't withdraw. Mr. Ishibaru. I have this opportunity. Let me say this right now.
That's it. I'm sure of it.
Destiny has bound me and her together in the Gordian knot of true love.
Guys, we need her to, or him to freaking hack the files.
Well, me and him have been melded together in the white hot heat of friendship. Is that what you call it? I think you call it something else.
Yeah, it's white and it's hot.
I think that heat is something other than friendship.
Yeah, I think so too. Hey, come on, you guys.
Moron! Talk down to me and I'll ram my fist right into all four of your vital points!
Well, I punch at the speed of sound! And I don't have any arm here, so there's no drag!
Enough already.
Knock it off, both of you.
Hey.
This doesn't belong to any one person. Chihiro left him to all of us. We can use him to finally gain access to the vital clues.
Kyoko's right. If anyone dares to serve our peace any longer,
hey!
They'll have to deal with me.
What?
Shit!
Anyway.
Until all three guys finish his work, don't do anything weird.
Too late.
Have I made myself clear?
Apparently not. I can't hear you.
I...
Yes!
Yeah.
Got it.
So then.
Okay then, let's get out of here. We can't afford to linger too long.
Hey!
Are you sure it's okay to let them off with a warning?
Indeed.
Yes, I have a plan. It'll be fine.
It involves tying a bomb to their ball sack.
After watching Ifumi and Taka leave dejected, we all head back to our rooms. It's still morning, but because of everything that's happened, I'm tired already. Well, anyway, I have to pull myself together. What should I do with the rest of my day?
Free time!
Yay! Hooray! How much longer do I have in this episode? I feel like it's been going on for a while.
Yes.
Let's find out.
Considering we saw the birth of Kiyano Ishida.
Yeah, we have 21 minutes left.
We can do a couple free time events.
Yeah.
So, now that you've had more info to go off on, who do you think dies?
It's between Ifumi and Taka.
You have to choose one.
I can't choose yet.
Okay.
I need more information.
Don't take too long.
Yeah, I'll go with Ifumi.
Are you gonna go with Ifumi again?
Yeah.
Oh my god. Because you can't talk to you can't talk to Kiyondo.
Right. So that's kind of void at this point. So I might as well get to know whoever I think might die, right?
It's like...
Yes? Since you need something?
Oh my god. Is he...
This might be one of the moments where they're too depressed to hang out, isn't it?
Oh my god, man. Let's see.
Because that actually happened with Chihiro when I played with Johnny.
If you don't have any business with me, please leave me alone.
I think that might be the case.
Well, you probably could.
No, I remember...
Well, out of respect.
I remember with Chihiro, when he was depressed about not being strong, you know, and the secret didn't reveal, blah blah blah.
You actually cannot hang out with, like, you could hang out with him, but he wouldn't give you any of that, like, the...
Oh, story.
Yeah, so...
Alright, let's find someone else. Someone that's not Keanu.
Great.
Let's see if Toko's in her room.
She is not.
Nope. No one's on the first floor.
Wow.
Who's on the third floor here?
Let's see. Sakura, Naoi, Kyoko...
Keanu.
Hiro and Celeste.
Do you think Celeste is taking all of his money?
I don't know. One of these three, I think.
Oh, if only you had a die.
Wait, which one was the one that I didn't go in yet?
What do you mean? You can go in all of them on the third floor.
Well, yeah, but I didn't get to explore one of them because of the...
The one in the physics lab.
Okay. So before I actually talk to anyone, I'm going to look around that room.
I love this room. It looks so sci-fi.
Yeah. I thought Kyoko was supposed to be in that room.
She was. The hell did she go?
Well, anyway, let's look around. I'm gonna get to say the same thing. Yep. Okay. Pendulums, wheels, rail segments, and equipment to scatter all over. They're all covered in dust too. They haven't been used in a long time.
Tarps!
This is a tarp. Pre-order the item overall.
Coin!
Gamble coin!
Okay. Anything else? Yes. Well, the monitor's on, obviously. Okay. And these files. There's a bunch of files here, probably old research data. Okay. That's everything in this room.
I kinda wanna see where Kyoko is in this room.
Yeah, like, where the heck is she? Is she, like, over in this corner or something?
Oh, she's behind the fucking machine! She's like, hello!
Since you hid from me, I'm gonna talk to you. Don't worry, I'm not gonna kill anyone. Yeah, I'll talk to her.
Yeah, I don't believe
it. It's true.
I was just about to head to the dining hall because I'm good drink. Did you want to come with me?
She's actually being social!
We went to the dining hall and drank some tea with Kyoko. Well, we're not in the dining hall room, so... We went all the way down to the first floor, and then went all the way back to the third floor. Okay.
Alright, let's try and give her something.
What would she like? Actually, do you think she'd like coffee?
Maybe. We give her... No.
She probably likes mystery things, right? Like mysterious?
I think so.
So like if I gave her like a serious tear or something, right?
No.
Oh.
I think that was her motto. Not motto, but Haka.
Okay. What about secrets?
What's this? That's a fighting thing. Oh. And plus we don't have one of those.
Oh, you're right, we don't. We gave that to Sakura. Millennium Crash.
These seven important mathematical problems were posed by the Clay Mathematics Institute with a reward of $1,000,000 for each one solved.
You think that one would be good?
I don't know. Mm-hmm. Let me try. It's a pagan answer.
What the hell?
Freaking witchy dude, bow tie.
What about this?
That's for Kyoko.
Of course it is. What would she like?
Let's try the problems.
Okay.
Just give her something.
So...
This is something you don't see too often. Do you mind if I keep it? I'd like to take a closer look at it. Does that mean you liked it?
Apparently.
Are you scared, Makoto? Huh?
Hey.
Being trapped in a place like this? Who wouldn't be? Of course I'm scared. Being trapped in this insane school.
Correct.
Ah, that's good. That's good?
So...
Fear is proof that your imagination is functioning. Frankly, I feel bad for anyone who can't fear. Without imagination, you can never deduce which action to take next. But what about you? You seem totally calm. You don't act afraid at all.
Wrong.
I'm scared too, of course. I simply hide my emotions. There's no advantage to be gained from letting others see how you feel. You hide, huh?
Correct.
What I mean is, I'm not as foolishly open as you are. foolishly open.
Listen.
Also, the fear I experience is a little different from yours, I imagine. Huh? What do you mean?
So...
You're afraid of what you might lose, right?
Correct.
But I'm afraid of what I've already lost. I'm sorry, I don't understand. I know. She didn't bother answering any further. She just turned
Goodbye.
And... Goodbye. With that, she was gone. Well, we're just getting to know each other. Maybe she'll talk more next time. I don't think I understand her all just yet. Alright.
More skill points!
Hooray!
Yay!
When we were all done, I headed back to my room for a little while. Oh, I figured it'd be nighttime, considering we had a long thing in the morning. Nope.
More free time!
Alright, well, let's see.
Can I pick one this time?
Yes.
Alright. Let's see. Ooh, there are people in different rooms.
Byakuya.
Nah. I don't want to be sad.
Can't talk to him. Hiro, Toko, and Kyoko, Oyen, Aoi, and Sakura, Celeste, Fufumi. And is that everyone?
I think so.
No one there. No one there. No one there. No one.
Okay, I want to see how Toko. I want to see how Toko is.
Toko?
Yes. If she's Genocide Jack, we won't be able to progress anything.
Okay.
So I want to see what she's like. So we just have to walk around to be. Oh wait, go back. I think it's here.
That's Kyoko.
Yeah, I'm there.
Oh, that's Genocide.
Son of a bitch!
Okay, so since she's Genocide, who do you want to talk to?
Open up the map again.
Uh-oh. Kitty.
Wait. Why do you want out?
Go on.
Let's go on.
Oh, now you don't want out. Okay, there you go.
You know what? Let's talk to Celeste.
Celeste?
Dark Queen.
Okay.
I want to talk to my Dark Queen. She's me anything for the blood sacrifice.
Wait, was she in this room?
No.
Shit.
She was in the kitchen.
Okay.
This is where Sad Chestnut is.
Hi, Sad Chestnut. Goodbye, Sad.
Waterlogged Chestnut.
pardon me. Okay.
You two have fun. We're gonna go back to Dark Queen.
Yep.
Then let's get over the rose whip.
The rose whip?
Yes, the whip.
Okay. Ah, okay.
That's me!
Shit! I forgot.
Lady, voice act, fucker!
Okoto, I should tell you, I have recently seen the shadow of death upon you. That's just a little joke.
Thanks, I guess.
It would seem I'm growing used to your deplorable face.
Thanks, I guess.
I always thought my face was deplorable.
This is another aspect of adaptation, I suppose.
Despite your thinly veiled insults, I spent some time with Celeste. Since I grew a little closer. Alright, so you said the rose whip?
Yes.
There it is.
There it is.
Interesting. The gods heard my prayer and my wish has been granted. This is all because of my daily sympathy and compassion, is it not?
Thanks, Celeste. So please, with something I gave her, it makes me happy.
She wanted a whip!
Yes.
Say, Makoto, do you like Mahjong?
I've actually never played.
Most unfortunate.
Is that so? A pity. I was hoping we might play together.
Are you good at it?
Yes, indeed.
Good? No, I am not merely good. I want to play a game of Russian roulette mahjong and won.
Oh. Russian roulette?
It was a truly fierce contest, put on by a half-insane billionaire in the basement of his mansion. My opponents were a fierce old man and a silver-haired boy who was said to have the devil's own luck. He played with a modified rule set. I remember well the glass tiles we used.
And you won?
Indeed.
I defeated them both at once. I'll never forget the angry, twisted looks on their faces.
Well, wouldn't that mean they would have to shoot themselves? Because of Russian roulette?
Maybe Russian roulette means they give them everything.
Maybe.
So it's societal death.
Yeah. The crowd that had been invited to watch became positively riotous. No one could believe I had won. That is one of my fonder memories. Oh, that was the memories.
I'm really glad I didn't agree to play Mahjong with her. Okay, well that was sorting to read into the
Mars coins!
Good! maybe I can equip everything again.
Oop!
Unable to comprehend Celeste's fearsome past, I went back to my room. And now it's nighttime.
It is nighttime!
Ding dong, ding dong. Same announcement as usual, I'm guessing.
I think.
Yep. Nice already. I guess I'll go to bed for today.
More Monokuma Theater.
Happy New Day! I'm the kind of guy. I don't only want to celebrate a new year. I want to celebrate the dawn of every new day. Because every new day deserves celebrating, so...
Once again, Happy New Day!
That one was really short.
Yeah, it was.
Good morning!
I better get to the dining hall. Sorry. I'm just replying to a text. I know it's very unprofessional.
We're never professional.
That's
kidding
true
me?
You're right, yes. Alright, well, anyone to talk to?
The...
I don't know, I'm just turning corners. That's my sound effect for it. Well, no one to talk to, so I guess I'll just go wait.
Oh!
Taka and Kyoko are not here today.
You know?
Yoko's still on guard duty, probably.
I have no idea about Taka.
Damnation!
May as well just forget about that guy.
So,
you don't have to get so mad.
You know?
They're rivals in love. What are you gonna do?
That's pretty much it!
Don't put me on the same level as that virgin! I might catch his virginity!
Hold on, that's not how it works. Are you saying you're not a virgin?
So did you tap someone? Did someone tap that?
Fascinating. Wait, if you were only interested in 2D, then how? How would you have lost it?
I mean, technically, he said 3D is only good for nude body, so...
Cosplay, maybe?
But...
Nah, my guess is you're already infected.
Oh!
Out here with the burns!
Gonna need a sensei for that one.
See it!
Wait,
see it!
You can really catch it?
Owie! I gotta just wanna end the video on this!
I can't... Hold on! I need help! I can't get up!
Here.
I gotta get into her voice again. Oh! Anyway.
Stop being vulgar. Let's eat breakfast.
I don't want to catch his virginity. Let's have breakfast.
But as soon as my hand approached my food...
Hey!
Ooh. Huh? That voice. The door to the dining hall exploded open, and my cat is scratching at the door. Hold on. Don't even bother asking why we arrived at the same time. The answer should be obvious.
Yep.
I'll give you a hint. I'm wearing red lingerie today.
That's very good to know.
I don't think anyone wanted to know.
I did.
Hold on a second. You.
Huh?
What's your top power level?
Like
35, 22, 33? You start out big on top to try to look thinner down south?
You
S.O.B. Lady of Melons! They're cities!
Why are you focusing? hold on, I wanna say this with this. I wanna say this with a semi-cute face. Okay.
What is your...
Did you catch like messing with something? You're messing with someone in the closet.
What are you doing?
Okay.
Look at your melons! They're seriously gargantuan! Do you dunk them in milk every night or something?
You're starting to freak me out.
No forgiveness!
If you lay a finger on Hina, I will show you no mercy.
Baby!
I literally let you back in just now! Literally just now! Why do you want out again? Why?
Always fun at the Jessport studio.
Goodness gracious.
So, what do you want? Surely you are not here to join us for breakfast.
Naturally. Of course not. I came to hear a story. A story? A story that nobody's bothered to tell me yet. I'm thinking about Alfrika.
Sorry, but we can't talk about that right now.
What?
Why not?
Because of certain circumstances.
Up till now you haven't given a crap about anything, and now you're all concerned? I don't buy it.
It's all clear now.
I just made a decision. When we get out of here, I'm going to feed your body to the vultures.
What kind of messed up dictator are you?
What?
But this isn't a democracy, or else what you would exclude those who don't fit into your tyrannical majority? I read that really weird. That's not what we're doing.
That's entirely what we're doing.
Well, whatever. If nothing else, tell me what's going on with Taka. When I saw him yesterday, I happened to notice something seemed off, so I was curious.
Only something?
Taka has become utterly useless.
Celeste, you don't have to say that.
Yes, I do.
That good thing, Dark Queen.
Did his spirit collapse or something? Was he unable to withstand this environment? Those men who clothe themselves in cheap fabric of justice are often the first to fall. But perhaps that will make things all the more interesting. Interesting?
Such ignorance.
Let me leave you with a bit of advice. Don't come to rely on a false camaraderie. Camaraderie, thank you. Or you will reap its bitter reward.
What the heck?
That's why you came? Just to give us this amazing advice? It seems I am unwelcome here. Then I will grant your desire and remove myself.
Yes.
Yeah! Well, let's get out of here!
Stop talking.
You didn't need to come with me.
Yep.
You don't have to play hard to get, Master! You can just play hard!
Whoa!
Shit!
Now you know why I wanted to voice it.
That doesn't make any sense. Bianca started to move slowly out of the room. I am not opening the door for you! Surging of speed, and very soon he was sprinting out of the dining hall.
Get out of the way! So now he's running hard to get! I see! Wait!
So, at the end there, what was that all about? Just now, Byakuya was all like...
Maybe he's like the main guy who starts acting different, or gets all flustered when things change.
Guess so. Both of us slept in the dining hall, finished our breakfast, and went back to our rooms.
How much time we have left on time?
Let me take a look.
Doo-doo-doo.
57 seconds.
Hey! Good place to end the episode.
Alright. Well, on the next episode...
We'll choose more free time.
Yeah. See you guys next time.
Bye.